Hi guys, this is Harish Bali from technofit.com. Creating a YouTube channel is a four-click process if you have a Google account. For those of you who don't have a Google account, go to YouTube, click on sign in, go to sign in with a different account, add account, click on create an account, put in all this information, name, current email address, password, confirm your password, your birthday details, gender, your phone number for verification, CAPTCHA, your location, and go to the next step. Just after filling this form, you can easily create your Google account. Once you have your Google account ready, sign in to the Google account by going to the youtube.com. For the purpose of this tutorial, I have already prepared a test account. Click on this image icon on the top, click on YouTube settings, look for this additional feature at the bottom of the screen and click on create a new channel. Write the name of your channel here. For example, I am trying to name my channel by my name, Harish Bali. Select a category. You can choose whether you are a product, brand, company, arts, entertainment, whatever. So I am choosing other. I agree to the terms. You can go ahead and read these terms. And done. Yes, you have added a channel to your account. That is how easy it was to create a channel. You can read this later on. There are a few things that you can do on your channel. First is you can create a channel icon. This is the place for your photograph. You can have your photograph or your company logo out over here depending upon the type and nature of your business. Click on this. Your channel icon is linked to your connected Google Plus account. Edits in Google Plus may take a few minutes to show on your channel. What that means is that it will take some time for this channel icon to appear. Wait for the new window to open. Click on select a photo from your computer. I have an image of self on my desktop. I am choosing it. So it will take some time to appear as a channel icon on YouTube. I can adjust the settings, set as a profile photo. I am a tech blogger. Share. Your photo has been shared. Next thing I need to do is go back to my YouTube channel and also have a channel art edit, which is a cover photo. I have a test cover photo for this, which is not exactly for my business, but I have put it. The recommended size for this cover photo is 2560x1440 pixels. File can be max 2 MB, and the recommended size for the channel art icon that we put was 800x800 pixels. It shows various versions of how it will look on desktop, TV and mobile. You can adjust and crop it if required. I am selecting it. This is how it appears on my channel. I have done two things. I have put channel icon here, which will appear in some time. You can have your company logo or your own image here depending upon nature of your business. This is like a cover photo. It's called as channel art in YouTube. I will also share with you how to add a video onto your channel. Click on videos link. You don't have any videos yet, upload a video. Select the file by clicking here. I already have a file. This is the video about how to use Dropbox to share files. So I have put that as a keyword on the file name. Select it, open. It'll take about half a minute or a minute to upload the video depending upon size of the video. Meanwhile, what you can do is you can go ahead and write the title. So this video is about how to use Dropbox to share files, which is fine as a title of the video. I can edit the first alphabet. Write description of the video here, which can be anything from 200 words to 400 or 500 words. So this is kind of a description of what the video is about. You must write tags here. These tags are like keywords for how people can search for your video. Like my video was about Dropbox, so I'll use tags like Dropbox, share files on Dropbox, how to share files on Dropbox. Similarly, I can go and add about 5 to 8 ads. Typically a tag count of 5 to 6 is decent enough. Then what you can do is you can add a personalized message for viewers of your video so that they see the message when they come to your video. After that, you can also go and check on the advanced settings. Put a video location if you want to, depending upon your nature of business. I can add this video to playlist. For example, I can go and create a playlist by the name Cloud Storage. If I wanted to have a couple of videos on Google Drive, SkyDrive or Dropbox, then this is the best thing to do, create. So this video gets added to the playlist. So people who come to my channel can see all the videos in cloud storage as a playlist. There are two more things you can do on your basic info page. You can choose the thumbnail of the video that you want to show on the search. Second thing is you can monetize your videos. So there will be a tab between basic info and advanced settings by the name monetization. I'll show you how it looks in other browser. So there will be a basic info, advanced setting and monetization. Check the boxes how you want to monetize your video and you can monetize your video. So let me go back. So assuming the description is there, already there. So I am publishing the video and your video goes live. This will also show the link on which your video appears. So that was all about YouTube channel and certain basic things. Let me now share with you some of the advantages of having a YouTube channel. Credibility. It gives official looks, unique identity. Then there is additional content like playlist, information. You can connect with your customers, share operations like process in a factory. You can also build connections like any other social media. Here you can go ahead and build subscribers. It also helps in building SEO ranking because it's an important off-page SEO parameter. You can go and have multiple channels, up to 50 under one Google account. You can also monetize your channel and can earn through AdSense. Do subscribe to my channel for more tech related stuff. Thanks for watching.